Sure that we go that way.
Ooh, be more careful next time you take a turn.
Can you at least let me hold the map?
Sure.
Oh, I didn't know these things could fly.
Oh, hi. You know, I never caught your name. You are?
Well, I'm Tip and this is Molly.
Oh, that's nice meeting you.
There's no snake chasing you, right?
Oh, well, while he was there, well, it looks like I escaped the grip of the snake once again.
What grip? Snakes don't have grips.
Oh, well, no, this snake, no, it's different. It's a different kind of snake. You've never seen it before. Wait, snake, grip, escape. Escape it. I have another story.
Huh?
Okay, you want to be like Paul, don't you?
Yeah, and?
Well, Paul escaped some people who wanted to kill him, too.
Which time?
Well, let me tell you all about it.
Paul had narrowly escaped death in Jerusalem. The Jews planned to kill Paul, but the Roman soldiers took him to Caesarea, where he would be safe. However, Paul was still a prisoner. The Roman leaders wanted to figure out why the Jews hated Paul so much. So Paul met with the rulers to try to explain what was going on.
First, Paul met with Felix the governor. Felix ordered the Roman guard to watch Paul, but to also give him some freedom by letting Paul's friends come and serve him. A few days later, Felix and his wife came for a meeting with Paul. Paul talked about faith in Jesus. He talked about righteousness and self-control, and he explained that one day, God is going to judge the world. Felix was afraid of what Paul said. He sent Paul away, but he met with him many times for the next 2 years. When a new governor came into power, Felix did not release Paul from prison.
The new governor was named Festus. He traveled to Jerusalem to meet with Jewish leaders. The Jewish leaders asked Festus to bring Paul to Jerusalem. They were still planning to attack Paul and kill him, but Festus wanted Paul to stay in Caesarea. He invited some of the Jewish leaders to go with him to see Paul. Paul stood before Festus. "I haven't done anything wrong," Paul explained again. "I want to see Caesar." Caesar was the emperor of Rome, and as a Roman citizen, Paul had the right to take his case to him. Festus agreed.
While Paul was waiting to go to Rome, King Agrippa and Queen Bernice visited Festus and Paul. Paul told the king how he became a believer. He explained that Jesus died and rose again to bring salvation to Jews and Gentiles. "You are out of your mind," Festus said. Paul said, "I am speaking the truth. I wish you and everyone who is listening might believe in Jesus." King Agrippa, Festus, and the others with them got up. They agreed that Paul had done nothing wrong. The king was ready to free Paul, but Paul had already asked to go to Rome.
God had chosen Paul to take the gospel to Gentiles, kings, and the Israelites. Paul met with people again and again to tell the good news about Jesus. He wanted everyone to believe that Jesus is Lord. Because Jesus has the power to save people from sin, Paul was willing to do whatever it took to share the gospel.
Paul is the man.
Oh, I know. He's totally cool. I mean, Jesus, way cooler. But Paul, he's pretty up there.
I agree. But how does this have to do anything with the snake?
Ah, young grasshopper. Don't you see? Paul escaped the grip of men because God had a great plan for him to share the gospel with others. For as long as the snake doesn't get to me, I will share the gospel news too. Oh, no, no. Today, snake.
Weird. As odd as he is, he's right about the importance of sharing Jesus with others.
Yeah, I'm 100% certain that we should share our stories of how Jesus saved us with others.
Hey, since we are going to share our stories with the Wallanaki people when we find them, why don't you practice by sharing your story with me right now?
I like that idea.
All right, I am all ears.
Okay, well, when I was 8, my dad got a new job. It meant I had to move away in the middle of the school year. It was a big change. During my first few weeks at the new school, I noticed that everyone around me had new things. They had brand new lunchboxes, backpacks, pens, and markers. And I didn't have anything like it. All the things I had were hand-me-downs. Because of that, people treated me differently. I didn't feel cool. But then, one day at school, at lunch, another kid named Ellie sat next to me. She talked to me and asked me about myself. I didn't think anyone cared about me, but Ellie made the effort to make me feel cared for, which was really cool. She even bought me a new case of markers. It was so kind. I asked her what made her do this, and she said she didn't like seeing anyone alone because Jesus wouldn't want people to be alone. I had never heard about Jesus before. So she invited me to church. That weekend, my whole family went to church on Sunday morning with Ellie's family. A few months in, I really saw a difference in Ellie's life and in mine too. I said, "I believe," because Jesus shows us he is always with us.
That is so beautiful, Tiff. It's such a powerful story of Ellie's generosity. I know this story will touch the hearts of all the Wallanaki people.
Thank you. We should keep on moving on so that we can share this amazing news of Jesus and our stories of how Jesus changed our lives.
Oh, keep it up, Tiff. I heard your story. You can share your story.
Hey guys, this month's memory verse comes from the book of Romans, a book that Paul wrote. It goes like this: "Love one another deeply. Honor others more than yourselves. Stay excited about your faith as you serve the Lord. When you hope, be joyful. When you suffer, be patient. When you pray, be faithful. Romans 12, 10 through 12. All right, now it's your turn to try it. Go ahead and stand up and let's do it all together on the count of three. Ready? 1, 2, 3. Love one another deeply. Honor others more than yourselves. Stay excited about your faith as you serve the Lord. When you hope, be joyful. When you suffer, be patient. When you pray, be faithful. Romans 12, 10 through 12. Great! One last time. Ready? 1, 2, 3. Love one another deeply. Honor others more than yourselves. Stay excited about your faith as you serve the Lord. When you hope, be joyful. When you suffer, be patient. When you pray, be faithful. Romans 12, 10 through 12. Awesome job. I'll see you next time.